Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Makeover shows used to be one of my favourite categories of TV show. Well, the makeover section of any TV show, and I'll be honest, in the UK, it was very, very subdued. We had how to look good naked, how to look 20 years younger, things like that. And they mainly focused on, and that pod thing with the lady from Atomic Kitten, but they mainly focused on fashion, hair, and makeup. And that was it, really. Nice little subtle changes that always seemed to make such a huge difference for the participant in the show. They were very, very tame, and overall more about having confidence in yourself and your style. There was a real feel-good factor. However, then Sky TV came along, right? Cable was introduced into the UK. Well, not to the UK, into my household. And along with that came shows like America's Next Top Model, Extreme Makeover, The Swan. And these are all shows about how much skinnier can you look, how much prettier can you look, about having mass surgery, and the money, you can tell the money they spent on these makeovers was on a completely different level of budget to what we had here in the UK. Full body makeovers, full fashion makeovers, full house makeovers, these are makeover shows at a different level. Madness. And to be honest with you, at that time, after watching the show, we'd be like, how inspirational, the lives they must have after this show. People's lives are gonna change forever, and they did. But not always for the best. I have a trigger warning for today's video. I know usually I show graphic pictures of surgery and stuff, but it's a little darker today. It's a little bit more upsetting. We're going to be talking about suicide, graphic surgery, body dysmorphia, depression, basically how these shows ruined people's lives. So before we get into it, I've cleansed my face using the Naturium Niacinamide Gelée. And I'm going to go in with a cooling, soothing kind of pad mask. I'm going to be using the Sue Good toner pads with cabbage centella and aloe, so really soothing, really nourishing, moisturizing, hydrating. I'm going to wipe them along my face, but then also just leave them on to help hydrate and soothe my skin. So Extreme Makeover, I think, is one of the most popular makeover shows, was one of the most popular makeover shows, both in the UK and the US. I think we had a UK version, but really the US version was popular in the UK. It first aired in December of 2002 and really was the first show of its kind in the sense that it was extreme. Taking people who thought their whole appearance needed a makeover and giving them an extreme makeover. But this show really did focus on things like fashion, exercise, makeup, and of course, plastic surgery. You're probably already familiar, but a quick rundown of the show is that each episode would take a participant away from their family, their jobs, their life, for about 2 to 3 months, sometimes even 4. They'd have their extreme makeover, and then their makeover, their new look, would be revealed to their friends and family, who they haven't seen for months right at the end of the show. They'd usually walk down from some stairs and everyone would be clapping, a little bit shocked, not really knowing what to think. Oh, you're not ugly anymore, kind of thing. The show actually ended in 2007, I think mainly because people were kind of wising up and thinking this is a very odd show, actually. So it would end in 2007, but not before a huge tragedy for would-be participant Deleese Williams. So I'm just going to wipe these off. These are so gentle, it looks like I'm rubbing, but these are the softest pads I've ever used. And they just glide over the skin. Deleese Williams was a would-be contestant of Extreme Makeover, and she was due to appear on the show. The crew actually flew out to Texas to interview her and her family, kind of interviewing for those confessionals. Deleese actually states that these confessionals and interviews were really, really hard to listen to. This was her friends and family saying some really nasty stuff about her appearance, but really down to the fact that the ABC staff were supposedly manipulating her friends and family into saying these really nasty things about her appearance. To build up some more hype for the makeover, to kind of make the before and after seem more drastic. One of the family members that was interviewed was her sister, Kelly McGee, and they really, really coaxed her into saying some awful, awful stuff about her sister. So production was going forward, and in January of 2004, Williams spent 2 weeks in LA, visiting doctors, a gym, the studio. Williams did actually see a psychologist, so some mental help was given to these participants prior to surgery, nothing after, but this is more than what we've seen a lot of makeover shows. Not saying it's enough, it definitely wasn't. Whilst doctors and surgeons, dental surgeons, started to literally list every kind of operation they thought they could give her. Not what she needed, but the amount of operations that would make a good before and after and good TV. So supposedly what she needed done includes, but isn't limited to, an eye lift, ears pulled back, chin implants and breast implants, dental surgery to break and reset her jaw for a more successful makeover, according to the lawsuit. However, on the night before all her surgery started, a producer from ABC actually visited her hotel room and told her that the makeover was cancelled. Literally all that for nothing. Why was it cancelled? Because her healing time wouldn't fit in with the show's schedule. And she was literally put on a plane home. That's it. After all this, everything she's been through, being told by people that her whole face needed correcting, her body needed correcting, after her family and friends have been forced into saying all this really nasty stuff about her, she was just returned home. I mentioned a lawsuit, and Williams is suing ABC, which we'll talk about again in a minute. Back in Texas, according to her attorney, Deleese tried to hide. She said her and her family were absolutely devastated, humiliated, crushed, and embarrassed, and overall ashamed about what they had supposedly been forced to say. Next up is the Glow Recipe Watermelon PHA BHA Pore Tight Toner. I love this for hydration and just kind of make my skin look better. Smaller pores, hydrated skin, gentle exfoliation. But it really was her sister Kelly McGee who felt the most crushing guilt from what she had been forced to say in these interviews. You know, she made all these nasty comments that she probably didn't even really think were true. As I mentioned, she was forced into it, quite possibly thinking, you know what, it'll be fine, she's gonna get her makeover. These comments, this interview will be a thing of the past. She's going to come out so much happier. But as the makeover never happened, McGee had a really hard time forgiving herself. 4 months later, McGee died of an overdose from prescription drugs and alcohol. Unfortunately, I can't find where this lawsuit goes, but Williams is suing ABC and the Walt Disney Company, the parent company, for alleged breach of contract, willful infliction of emotional distress, and negligence. Williams' lawyer, Wesley Cordova, said Extreme Makeover found a family that was coping with issues and left them devastated, and one person died as a result. With the lawsuit going on to say that Deleese does actually blame herself for her sister's death. She says in the lawsuit that through all this, my friends and family who have never said anything before have said things that made me realize that yes, I was right and everyone did think I looked like a freak. ABC did release a statement saying the ABC television network wishes to express its sincere condolences to Deleese Williams and her family for the loss of Kelly McGee. In regards to Extreme Makeover, all participants are made aware that if doctors or producers have any concerns about a procedure, the makeover will not go forward. The producers endeavor to handle each potential makeover participant with the utmost care. Deleese says that she's left too embarrassed and ashamed to even show her face in public now. This big event that was meant to completely change her life for the better has absolutely destroyed it. There is something to be said for the lack of care for reality TV contestants overall. They never receive any mental health support. Yes, they see a psychiatrist throughout the procedures, but it's not really throughout the procedures, it's for the show. A lot of past contestants say that they saw these psychiatrists and experts when they were filming, and that was it. That was it. So that's maybe 5 times in 3 months. And then there's no aftercare. Whether you've had surgery or you've just been on a reality TV show and you're now a celebrity, it's a huge change. It's a huge change. A lot of these things are in complete captivity and then you're released into the wild and you're a completely different person and everybody knows you. There is no mental health support for how to deal with that or how to deal with the press, how to deal with the hate, how to deal with the fact that your face looks completely different and you appear to be a completely different person. There has been a string of suicides from reality TV stars and absolute horror stories of how some of these contestants, like Deleese, can't even leave the house anymore. I truly believe these producers don't care. These people aren't people to them. They want money, they want their ratings and views, and these very real people in these shows are nothing but props to them, and this is evident through horrific stories like this. Oh, I'm gonna go in the Peach Slices Snail Rescue Intensive Serum with 95% snail mucin concentrate. This has really just been, again, another skin-soothing, repairing product. I'm not really massively keen on the squeezy packaging. It comes really hard to get out the closer you are to the bottom of it. And it also feels like there's like nothing in there sometimes, but it has been great at like just really soothing, calming, and repairing. We know that's what I love in every single product. I'm about to get a little bit shallow, but this was past me, okay? I just wanna say how past me was this. The Swan. I was obsessed with this TV show. This was a makeover show like no one had ever seen before. As the name suggests, the swan centers around an ugly duckling, which was to be transformed into a beautiful swan, purely done through extreme surgery. The whole thing about this show, I remember before it even launched, the before and afters whipped up like such a media frenzy because they were unbelievable. They didn't even look like the same person. I thought it was a joke. And I feel like that's what really got the show the ratings, and that's what they wanted. But unlike a lot of makeover shows that we've seen, diet, nutrition, exercise, mental well-being was not one of the main parts of this show. It was clearly about, and sometimes it was when it would benefit the storyline, looking back on it now, but other than that, not a key part at all. Each week's episode would feature a transformation of two ladies. They'd have these huge surgeries, right? And then at the end, there'll be a big mirror behind a curtain, and the mirror, the curtain would open. They'd see their transformation after not seeing themselves for like, again, like 3 to 4 months, sometimes even longer. A whole moment where they're like crying and shaking and they're so happy and they can't recognize themselves. And then those two participants from that episode, one would go home and then one would go on to compete at the end of the series in a beauty pageant with all the winners of each episode competing, with the winner being crowned the swan. I hate to say this, but at the time, I loved the concept. I was like, this is such a clever concept. You know, from ugly duckling to beauty queen, so shallow. Like, it was ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. It would be cancelled after only 2 seasons, and it would go down in history, according to Vice, as the most bizarre and offensive reality TV show of all time. But according to one of the contestants, Belinda Bessant, it sounds like the contestants didn't actually know the full concept of the show or what was actually going on. Yes, they knew they were getting their transformations, but they didn't actually know they were competing. Belinda said she was a single mom, she was depressed, and it was just one of those bad moments in life where she felt really, really, really down. And one day she was watching TV, she saw an advert pop up on the bottom saying, "Have you ever wanted to change your life? Go to this website." So she did. It was a casting call for The Swan. She says, 4 months after the initial casting in Las Vegas, I was flown out to LA where I was given a whirlwind of medical and psychological tests. 2 months after that, cameras showed up at my house in Vegas to film B-roll. And the next morning, producers called and said, "Get ready to go, you're leaving in 2 days. She says by that time, she'd gotten over her initial low slump and was actually fine. Like, she didn't really want to go through with it, but it was too late and she kind of dedicated herself to it now. Before she went on, she had a lawyer look through the contract and he basically said, you shouldn't do this. You shouldn't go on this show. But she did anyway. She said the thought of being on reality TV was way too attractive for her. Too exciting for her to turn down. She said she had 2 days to quit her job or tell them she was going away on holiday for 4 months, leave her family, leave her life behind for 4 months. She said the first thing she filmed was her standing in granny panties, she calls it, against a green screen, turning around while surgeons basically shouted what they can change about her. All the surgery that she can have. Basically saying the more you can have done, the better. So Bessant actually ended up having blepharoplasty. I don't know what that is. She had an operation where the fat was taken out from her cheekbones. She had her teeth done. She had veneers, a breast reduction, and a bunch of liposuction. All the surgeries were within the first 2 weeks of her being on this show. Her first operation was 13 hours under anesthesia, and her second was 1 week later. She goes on to say that up until the final month, so the fourth month, out of the 4 months she was going through all this surgery, too late, she signed her contract, she's on the show, she had no idea that the concept of the show was to then compete in a beauty pageant. So they actually all filmed this together. Whilst they put two contestants together, all of the season one people were going through this all at the same time. So they were all recovering together. She said they were all great friends. And the idea of competing was kind of weird because now they suddenly felt this kind of like extra pressure to prove themselves as the swan. You know, was their transformation worthy of being pretty, basically? So that's kind of an interesting behind the scenes. From what we know, she's okay now, but for some contestants of The Swan, things got a lot worse once they got home. I'm gonna go in with the hyaluronic acid 3 serum from COSRX with amino acids and ceramides. This is just, again, skin barrier strengthening, fortifying, one of my new favorite serums for glowy, healthy skin. Lorrie Arias, I think I'm pronouncing her surname right, sorry if I'm not. She is known as the Swan contestant, and maybe, quite possibly, the contestant throughout all makeover shows to have the most amount of surgeries done. She was 34 when she went on the Swan and had roughly over £300,000 worth of surgery done. Dollars, sorry. And they kind of centered her story around her weight loss. She had lost a ton of weight before applying for the show, so she had a lot of excess skin, which is to be expected. But she was also still mourning the death of her husband 2 years after he passed away. And you can tell they were really trying to push that on the show. As I mentioned, they did get a psychiatrist when it suited the storyline. But do I think the producers really cared? No, I think it was just to add to the storyline. This isn't a show that cared about how you felt inside. It was truly all on the outside. As I mentioned, the ladies didn't really know what they were getting into. I don't think the producers told them everything they needed to know. So her hope was to kind of go on the show and get a tummy tuck, get rid of some of that excess skin. But ended up getting tummy tuck, a butt lift, an inner thigh lift, dual facelift, upper lip lift, upper and lower eye lift, endoscopic brow lift, rhinoplasty, breast augmentation, and a breast lift. All that surgery and her reaction on the show, you think, wow, she must be living her best life now. She looks completely different. Like, this transformation was on another level before and afters. However, quite the opposite. An exclusive interview with HuffPost Entertainment back in 2017. She said that after the show, she was left feeling depressed, bipolar, agoraphobic, and suffers from body dysmorphia. She said that once she got home, she felt like a lot of her friends were actually very jealous of her transformation. And others didn't recognize the person, not only how she looked, but how she had become after the show. It's not to say that she was stuck up or arrogant, but she just, you know, she was in this headspace that she couldn't cope with because she got no help. According to the article, she raved about her plastic surgeon, Dr. Randall Hayworth. She says she was blessed to have him, absolutely no issues with him whatsoever, and how he handled the contestants throughout the show. But she does blame the show for not providing adequate therapy to help process such an extreme change. As I said, there's always this big reveal, right? The huge curtain pulls back and there's a mirror and they see their reaction. She looked happy. And, you know, I saw this quote from her that she said, when the camera pulled back, she says she reacted quietly whilst the cameras were rolling. She says, however, once backstage, she lost it. She says she was screaming for the executive producer. She said, I was screaming, I want my face back. And when you watch the reveal back, she can't look at her face. Like, you're looking at her, she can't look at her face. She's looking down at her body and she won't look at her face. Dr. Paul Puri, a psychiatrist, comments on possibly why these contestants aren't happy, truly happy, after their extreme makeovers, saying that many times an individual believes getting surgery will fix it. In the research and literature, this has not been shown to be a solution. It can be a problem with self-esteem, anxiety, or other underlying issues, and surgeries don't typically solve those other issues. And Arias agrees with the statement, basically, saying that it was her mental health that she needed help with. She had all the surgery, but once she got back home, all those old feelings came back to her. And of course, once she got back home again, she had no help from the show. There was no kind of like downtime. There was no therapy after. For a show that does such intense kind of like medical and surgery checks beforehand, they did nothing after. There was no aftercare whatsoever. I'm not 100% sure what she's doing today. I do see her in a lot of red carpet appearances, but she continues to be open about her struggles on the show and after the show. And it was really down to her and her being so open and vocal about her experience that the celebrity Swan was actually cancelled. There's actually a ton more horror stories from the Swan. This show alone, the dentist having their license taken away, the psychiatrist actually getting their license from an online course. The fact that they had all these surgeries all at one time, you would never do that in real life. Like, the pain and discomfort they must have been going through. However, season one winner Rachel Love, upon seeing the media talking about how unhappy a lot of the contestants were after that show, called them all crybabies. She says, what do you expect? Like, what do they expect? Reality shows aren't there to guide you for the rest of your life. I mean, I feel like they should do. Not for the rest of your life, but they should have a responsibility to care for you after for such extreme changes. As I mentioned, The Swan was one of my favourite shows. I hate saying it. Great format, horrible format at the same time. But I do feel like growing up, life was very shallow. We had the rise of reality TV, all based in Hollywood and surgery and tanning and bleaching your hair. And, you know, America's Next Top Model was hugely popular and everyone wanted to be a model and everyone was like doing model poses. You know, it was an end of an era where people stopped posing like with their families and selfies were becoming popular and people were knowing their angles and how to pose. And the first time in our lives, people were like liking pictures and things like that. And definitely as a preteen, I was around this time, I fell into that idea of you have to be attractive in order to get good attention, succeed in life. It was all about looks, and it's kind of embarrassing looking back on, but you know, I love this. I was like, yeah, she's so much better now. She's going to do so well. What we know today and what I know now today is looks really don't, I know it's cliche to say, but it does not change your quality of life in any way. Especially now we know how fake reality TV really is, and the fact that these producers who are creating these like subs, not sub stories, but you know, we feel bad for these people. We want them to have a better life, but the producers themselves don't. They don't care. They're playing on their insecurities, create entertainment, and they don't care. They love it. In fact, the before and afters in a lot of these weight loss shows, the lives they were living before aren't even real. I did an Instagram versus reality about fitness models before, which I'll link down below, but they made up a lot of stuff. An extension of the Extreme Makeover show was Extreme Weightloss Makeover, and contestant James Garrison actually went against his contract and his NDA to whistleblow basically on the show. I'm gonna apply the Axis Y Made For Me By Me Biome Recharging Enhanced Night Balm. It's a lovely day cream as well. It's light, moisturizing, skin barrier repairing. Now this show, Extreme Weight Loss Edition, usually takes place over the span of a year. So a bit more realistic, right? You have a year to change your life, change your dieting habits, your, what's the word? Fitness. I'm not familiar with it, but fitness routine. And James Garrison actually lost 300 pounds on the show. Super impressive. Impressive, very impressive, but that was the idea of these extreme weight loss shows. And of course, on the show, they celebrated this. They made a huge deal out of it, but what they didn't show was the health issues he was going through at the same time, due to the rapid weight loss. And there's some juicy stuff here, so I'm just gonna bullet point them. One, they were asked to gain weight for the initial weigh-in. Again, producers faking these before and afters to make them more impressive. Two, they were put on dehydration and herbal diuretics from Thursdays to Sundays to help fudge the weigh-in numbers to look more inspiring. They were told this was no big deal. It was for a clean weigh-in. Basically, they told them everyone on The Biggest Loser does it and it's perfectly safe. They go on to say that for all the phase goals, which I'm guessing is like you need to reach this big next goal to move on to the next phase, they would do an extra special flush, which helped them appear as though they had lost an extra 20 to 30 pounds. Chris Powell, who was basically the fitness expert, nutrition expert on the show, has always advised against doing this kind of thing on every show he has ever been on when he's talked about fitness. However, he was fine to do it on the show, supposedly. Why? For money, fame. Here is a show where he can showcase all his clients losing so much weight. They were made to take diet pills 2 to 3 times per day for an entire year. You are advised to take them for no longer than 6 weeks. To do it for a year is so dangerous. Even doing it for 2 weeks is so dangerous. However, the rapid weight loss, as we said, ended in some really difficult health complications for Garrison. He says that the weight loss led to severe dehydration, and he also got a massive gallbladder, a pancreatitis infection, which almost took his life, and ABC were not willing to pay the bill for that. So even when we're presuming that everything is being done safely and healthy, diet, exercise, nutrition, they're cheating. They're actually putting the contestants' lives at risk in order to make that before and after seem so much more grand. Like their life has changed forever. For ratings, for views, they do not care about these participants. I'm going to finish on a fragrance, Milk by Commodity, one of my favorite fragrances. Commodity do some amazing fragrances. I don't know what it smells like. Like light musk, very warm, very like creamy, but not like dry milk. I love it so much. Let me know if you watched any of these shows, what you thought about them at the time and what you think about now down in the comments below. It's just mind blowing. Like, looking back now, they're the worst shows ever. Ever, ever, ever. Let me know. Thanks again so much for watching. You can watch some general light entertainment here and a whole When Beauty Turns Ugly playlist here. And I'll see you over there.